right, Deputy Commissioner Worley?
Yep. Good afternoon. I'm Deputy Commissioner Rich Worley. With me are Colonel Jones, Kevin Jones from Patrol, and Lieutenant Colonel Mark Howe from Patrol. Around 12.06 p.m. this afternoon, Eastern District officers responded to the 1100 block of East Chase Street in reference to an individual suffering from a behavior crisis. Upon arrival, they spoke to a family member who produced a protective order for the individual. Officers confirmed the protective order, entered the house. As they entered the house, the individual attempted to elude the officers. A struggle ensued as they tried to take him into custody. During the struggle, he was able to get to a weapon that he had on his person, shot one of our officers in the leg. A second officer was able to apply a tourniquet to the injured officer. He was transported by officers to the hospital. The suspect was taken into custody without any officers firing any shots and without any injuries. Another example of officers doing a fabulous job in a very dangerous situation with an individual with a weapon. It was a family member who called and said he was suffering from a behavior crisis, hadn't taken his medicine, was acting violently.
The city recently established a crisis hotline.
Yes, sir.
Is that used as well, or would that have saved an officer's trip out here, or what is it necessary?
We do not know if that was used or not, but the officers were called here by an individual, by a family member who said the individual was inside of the house and was suffering from a behavioral crisis. Preliminary information is they were not sure whether he was armed or not. We're still investigating all the information that came in from the call.
Can you confirm if the individual inside the home was his mother? And you said that she had taken a protective order out. When was that done?
We're not going to confirm who the relative was. And the relative met the officers outside of the house. The individual was inside of the house, and when we went in to take him into custody, the officers read the protective order. It was still valid according to what they read. And as they entered the house to take him into custody, he attempted to elude officers and they attempted to take him into custody.
Kendall?
Mental health issue with the suspect. Do you know if the gun was legal that he had? Can you talk to us about that?
We do not know. We know that he was able to, during the struggle, he was able to get to a weapon that he had on his person and shot the officer in the leg.
WBAL?
Have you been to this house before? Have officers received any calls?
We're still investigating that right now. It's still very preliminary. The officer has a gunshot wound to the thigh. The second officer, who, by the way, is an officer who's in field training, applied the tourniquet and probably saved the officer's life. He has non-life-threatening injuries. He's being treated at a local hospital.
Last question.
Do we have any details on how long this officer has been with the force?
We do not yet. We're still confirming all that and talking to the family members and everyone.
Thank you, guys.